Wow, look at us. 20 episodes into the Junk Drawer series, one full year since I started making Minecraft videos, and we just hit 400 subscribers. That's pretty neat. Hello all, and welcome to Minecraft Junk Drawer, where if I build something once, I cannot build it ever again. Last week, we built that last building block there. I try not to build the same thing twice, and that mega base was one of the only exceptions because I kept adding to it, but I think we're done adding to it. But yeah, welcome to the 20th episode of Minecraft Junk Drawer. This is so exciting. This is the longest series I have ever done, which honestly isn't saying much. I haven't gotten past 10 episodes of anything yet, but it's fine. I'm really happy with the way this place is turning out. Oh, I should probably address the elephant in the room, which is attached to my back. Yes, I do have a cape. I got this on accident. Okay, maybe I should take off the wings. They do look really cool on the wings, though. Does this? Oh, it does work from behind. Why would you want this? I got this on accident when I first got Minecraft because I accidentally downloaded Bedrock first. I meant to get Java Edition. I guess there was like a whole little reward thing happening at the same time that happened. I had no clue. I honestly didn't even know that it was a reward for something. I just logged in and it's like, oh, look, I have a cape option. That's cool. And then my friends saw it and they were like, how the heck do you have a cape option? So that's kind of neat. I just put it on to see what it looked like with the wings because I just remembered that I had it, and I kind of like it. It's kind of bizarre looking, but I'm just gonna leave it for now. See how many people get upset about it. Oh, also, thank you all so much for 400 subscribers. I might get zappy about it later in the episode. Just thought I should warn you. Anywho, okay. Lagged? I lagged. That was actually lag that time. So, these guys need someplace to go. It has been, how long have you guys been here? It's like, since episode 2, 3, 2, 3. I don't remember. I think it was 3. I'm pretty sure it was 3. So they've been here for about 17 episodes, have been sitting in the quote unquote temporary pen since episode 3. I think these guys need a place of their own. Also, counter-revolutionaries. I said I was gonna build you a house the day I got you, and that was like episode 2. You've been waiting so patiently. I think, yeah, he deserves a house as well. And I'm thinking, oh gosh, I haven't walked in here in so long. Oh, nostalgia. Hasn't even been that long, but nostalgia. I'm thinking about reusing my starter base because right now it's just got a bunch of empty chests, one of my first crafting tables, and my little smelting space. I don't even have the bed in here anymore. It never makes sense to me in other people's Minecraft worlds where they just leave their starter base. They don't do anything with it after they've moved on to like their storage room or their mega bases or anything. Their starter base just sits there, just empty and never used. So I want to reuse it for something. And I think I'm going to give it to counter-revolutionaries because it just makes sense to me today. But first we're going to do the sheep pen. There is a little bit of a problem here though. I don't know where to put it. We've got a nice little area over there, but that might not be big enough for what I have in mind. This area definitely would be, but there's a little bit of a problem with it, and that is that it is sand. Sand on its own isn't that big of a deal. However, sand with a cave underneath it definitely is. Yeah, I don't really know how to terraform this area if that's what I decide to do. I guess I could use sandstone to like cover it up. It would be really nice to be able to fill this space with something. Oh, there's a jelly cat now. I think I have like 4 cats around. I guess we could try to terraform this area. We need something over here. I'm tired of walking around it and being like, I should put something here, but what would I do? Because there's a freaking cave. Well, let's do a little terraforming first then. To self, almost fell off to my death. There's a slime chunk down there. This dude's been going for like a full minute. Oh, okay, never mind. He spun out of existence. Got the terraforming done. I just used up what I had on my person, so I'm not too worried about covering up the entire thing, but I got most of the big gaps filled. I terraform kind of weird. I don't like to terraform too much. I kind of like to build my stuff around the way the ground lays, but that's because I'm gonna fill in any part of the build that's not actually touching the ground. I'm just gonna fill it in with something else. It'll make sense once I start building. So without furthering the ado, and as it starts raining, typical, I'm just gonna start building the thing, and you're gonna watch me do it, whether you like it or not. That's not a threat. It's not a threat. You can leave anytime. But please stay. This one's gonna be fun. I'm just gonna start the things before anybody starts actually leaving. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Let's start off by collecting my block palette, which in this case ended up being some very time-consuming shades of white. And now I'm gonna use those blocks to lay down the main circle of the build. Why have I been building so many circles recently? And like always, I'm gonna overthink the circle completely and then take it down and try again. And when I'm done overthinking, that means it's time to start in on the walls of the build. Now first of all, bone blocks have a really fun sound. And second of all, these walls were really bizarre. So bizarre, in fact, that I decided to take them down completely and start over again because my overthinking decided to come in for another visit. On this particular occasion, it was telling me that the entire build was just a little bit too round, which just wasn't the shape that I was going for. This is Minecraft, for crying out loud. So once I was done being completely counterproductive, I finally got back to building up the really weird walls. And whenever I remembered, I textured them with mushroom stem as I went. Then I sealed off the ceiling with a fun little swirl pattern for my own entertainment. Then it was time for the fun part. Also, yes, I do realize that I switched verbal tenses halfway through the description. The English teacher inside me is screaming, but I'm just gonna ignore it. And the fun part was to place down all of these random blocks that look completely out of place if you don't know the context of the build, and I'm not gonna tell you it, so stay tuned until the end if you want it to make sense. Also, I was listening to the Infant's Kiss podcast while I was working, and in retrospect, it was really funny that I decided to record this particular part. And you'll find out why once recording as he starts talking again.
You left in this clip where you were trying to say something and you just couldn't get it out. And it de-evolved into a space where you weren't even speaking real words.
No.
And you just went with it.
Then I remembered that I need to put a door somewhere in the build before I let some of those random blocks spill into the interior to mix with the dirt and grass. Then I added in some of my favorite containment units, which were oak fences and gates in this case, and some of those oh-so-important azalea leaves. Then it was just a matter of adding in some lanterns to make sure that the sheep were the only mobs inside, and a lucky little dandelion to tell me that I was done. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go tell my inner English teacher that I'm sorry. Well, I've technically already done this once, but there's a little bit of a technical issue. The connection between my microphone and my computer was not working, so I recorded it without my audio. So it's totally fine. I did lose a little bit of footage, but that's okay because there's another technical issue, which was that the connection between my head and my mouth was also not working. So I was kind of just stammering my way through the entire thing. It's been a week. Still not entirely over it. I'm still having a little bit of trouble speaking, but we're gonna go with it anyway because I need to finish the video. So before all my technical issues set in, I was able to build, oops, that's the back of my head, this. You probably can't tell what it is. Like most of my builds, I probably have to tell you, it's a laundry basket. And all this colorful stuff out here is the laundry spelling out. It landed in the world upside down, you know, like you do. As soon as I figured out that I would need somewhere to put my sheep, this was one of the first things that came to mind. And I am pretty happy with the way it turned out. I think it's kind of fun. And I've already moved the sheep in. And, yeah, okay, I need to cut those vines. That is a lot more of you up there than there used to be. They're loving it. They got grass. They've got room to move around. Okay, I can't do it while everyone's in front of the door. Please clear out. No, that is the opposite of what I want. Thank you, gray sheep. Lead the pack. There we go. You might want to come down from there. Ooh. That was a lot of you. This one was a lot of fun to build, actually. And I finally got to use some of these weird blocks, like the Nylium and the red mushroom block. This one is so much fun. I've been looking for an excuse to use this, but I've never really had a palette that could fit it in. But it's so perfect for this. It's so vibrant, and I love that it has this natural pattern. Same with the honeycomb. I have way too much of this stuff, and I need to find more places to put it. But that just leaves the house for counter-revolutionaries, which I also did. Well, my audio was not working, so, Okay, buddy! Are you excited? You better be excited. This took all of, I don't know how long, not very long, but oh well. You ready to see your new house? Here we go. Here we are. This is for you. And you don't need this lead anymore, finally. No more leads for you, I promise. First the wandering trader, now me. Nope, you're done now. You're a free llama. Ignore the fence. Looking around, you like it? Do you like it? Oh, he loves it. I'm pretty happy with the way it turned out. I mean, it's really simple. I didn't have to do too much to it. I just know that this guy likes wheat, so I put some hay bales in here, put in some grass. I give him a little blanket with his favorite color on it, put in some more of the dead coral for some, like, tumbleweed effect kind of thing. And I got to use these new pots, finally. I remembered that I had the shards for them. So we got shelter and angler
and Snort, which is apparently a stiffer design. I thought it was the pig design, but apparently not. And the miner run. And we still have access to the top. We still have access to the plant. Don't worry. I made sure we would... Oh, we would... Can I? Hold on. There we go. We can still get up to the plant. I like being able to, like, parkour around here. Make it to the top and look over my domain. Domain? That's a word. Yep. This is my domain. I told you words were hard today. And you know what? From up here, it does look pretty cool, but I really want to finish some of the paths, so I think I'm gonna do that real fast. Well, we may not get all of the paths done today, but I'll get just enough done that we could probably do a little walkthrough of the world. Okay. Are the paths done? No. No, they are not. But do I care? No. Even more no. I do not care. And neither should you, because you know what? They're started. I know exactly where all of them are going to go. I just do not have the time or patience to cut down any more trees for the wooden bits. And I've already gone through an entire Imp and Skiz podcast. I'm not doing this anymore. So instead of finishing the paths in their entirety, because that's going to take forever, I am going to take you on a little walk around tour of the world because nobody asked. You know what? We're testing out the pathway. We're alpha testing. It means that not all the details are in place, but we're going to make sure it works. So we're going to start here at the starter base, because what a great place to start. It's in the name. From here, we go to the magic school bus, because that's what we made in episode 2. And I still absolutely love this build. This is so much fun. It definitely needs more books in it, but it's fine. It's functional. And it took us a little while to get these spruce trap doors, but I am still so proud of this particular design choice, because that's how you hide the bookshelves. And then cutting through the garden, because I'm ignoring the paths that I so much time to make. We're gonna go to the milk bottle, or the milk jug. I never really figured out what this is. This is just a quick way to hide the cow crusher, the cow compactor, which is already still working very well. I'm not gonna go by order of episodes. I'm just gonna go by order of what I see in front of me. So here's the storage room. I am still, hang on, I gotta go back up the stairs. So happy with the way that this turned out. And for those of you who don't know, this is Ramona. For one of my first, what's supposed to be human looking organics, it turned out pretty well. I know some people commented and were like, it looks like something else entirely, but I don't care. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. And the box underneath was not gonna be there, because I did the bust in creative to make sure it would work. And it did, but not in the way that I wanted it to. So I built the box underneath. That was a very last minute addition, but I am so happy with the way it turned out. And one of my favorite things is that it looks so much different on the inside than it does on the outside. Like, say what you want about diorite, but this is, in my opinion, this is gorgeous. And a lot of people kind of gloss over storage rooms, but you spend so much time in a storage room in a Minecraft world. So I'm happy that I took the time to make it look pretty. And then we got Hippo and Dizzy. Disestablishmentarianism and Hippopotamonstrosis Quipedaliophobia. Love you both. Thanks for being with me. Let's go around the back. And then we got the designated tree growing area, which has not gotten a catchier name since I built it. And the main feature of that is the plastic trowel. And we loop around to the sniffer nest. Hey buddies, do you have any gifts for me? You do, thank you. And then we got the building block base. This is a fun concept. It filled the space quite nicely. Out of all these, this is my favorite. I absolutely love the snowy forest. I made this one in my episode where I was sick and couldn't talk. So it's kind of a weird one, but I absolutely love it. I love the custom trees. I love how none of this is actually snow. It's just wool and concrete because I didn't have snow. I barely had spruce. It's definitely one of the prettier blocks around here, unlike some of them. Although this is always fun, just being able to like walk in and swim no matter where you walk in and swim. Again, fun concept. Weird structure, but that can be said about a lot of the builds in this series. And then we've got the villager sandcastle. Oh, and the balcony that you cannot get up to, because there's no longer a second story, because they kept climbing the ladders. Yeah, all of you dudes. And again, I'm glad I made the interior of this kind of presentable, because I do spend quite a bit of time in here as well trading with these guys. Hey, I'm also still looking for names for these four new villagers, because I don't want to have to name them after phobias I find in the dictionary. You have been warned. If you have any name suggestions, I will gladly take them down in the comments below. Then we go down here. And again, the path is not finished. We got the laundry basket. We already saw that today. We got the bee lantern. And those of you who are new probably had no clue what this was. It is supposed to be a lantern. Then we run around past the wheat field. I counter revolutionaries. To the bee farm, which is a beachside cafe. Well, not even beachside. It's like on the ocean. And this bee farm has been... it's too much. I don't know what to do with this Motani comb. Although it is a very... very pretty shell. I keep saying that every single build is my favorite. This might actually be my favorite, because not to mention it's like my favorite block palette ever. And this build just looks absolutely amazing, especially in the rain, which is a must for me. I'm saving the mega build for last because all the glass bridges. I don't know. I feel like these are very overlooked and very looked through, but I absolutely love these. This was like top of my list when I first came up with the Junk Tour series. This was something I always wanted to do, is like, nobody has made a bridge out of glass that I know of, that I have seen, and I it is the coolest thing. It is possibly even cooler in my head than it is, I mean, all the way around. This is possibly cooler outside of my head than it was in my head, and that doesn't happen very often. I am so proud of these. I think they are really cool. I forget about the stuff over here pretty easily, but this is the sugarcane farm. This is the build I came up with based off of a random word. I am so happy with the way the computer turned out. Like, this kind of old school box computer is what I started playing video games on. And by video games, I mean like computer games that you had to put the disc in the tower and I'm old, okay? We got the fidget play structure. I don't think I use this nearly as much as I should, but it's so much fun to use. Like, just, there's so many flippy things. And this is, hang on, I gotta, here we go. Secret tunnel. Yay, okay. How could you not? How could you not love this? This is so much fun. I'm gonna build one of these in all of my worlds. I'm definitely not. I would like to though. Oh, and this one, I was worried I'd forget about this one. The fishing dock. This one's pretty familiar if you watched last week's episode. The book dock. I love it. So pretty. Turned out even better in retrospect than it did in the moment. Although most of my builds do. I actually hate my builds right after I've built them. And then after I've edited the video and had some time to look at them. And after knowing that you guys like them, that helps a lot. I start to warm up to them and they start looking more in place. And then just in case you're curious what this creepy little house is for, this is my AFK spot. And we go across the second glass bridge. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. To the iron farm. Path's not done. Insert shush here. This is also the entrance to my strip mine, which I will not be falling down. Kind of just linked up to this thing. I don't really need a full build around this. I might do it later if I think about it. But this was... I love this so much. I love that it tells a story. That is one of my favorite things about building, is when they tell stories. But I am pretty happy with the design of some of these. I love the umbrellas. I love the lounge chairs. I love the chain link fence made out of an iron bars. But I just love how grungy it looks. I love ruining my builds. It's just so much fun. I don't know why. I can't keep any of my builds like fully intact. Then we go in here, and this is the lava farm, which I need to AFK again because I keep forgetting. It's kind of weird. I kind of like doing the backs of builds. I mean, it's kind of annoying because you rarely ever see them, but I like fitting in details that only I get to notice. Like, this right here is like a boiler, and then I like to have roof access on all of my builds that are actually like house builds, because I love being able to go up on roofs, and I love the glass roof in this one. I forgot this was up here. Oh my goodness. This is such a cool detail. See, this is why we do this. I keep forgetting what all I have built on this series. And then you probably thought I forgot about it, because I did, but I just remembered. So I will show you again. The mob farm. Okay. I know this one's not like a typical like junk drawer build because I didn't make it look like anything in particular, but for my very first mob farm, the fact that I made it look like anything other than just wood planks at all is a pretty decent feat for me. And can she land it? Nope, she can't. I can never land this. Nope, never mind. You know what? I'm out of rockets. I don't... Oh, I'm not out of rockets. Oh, and I'm upside down in my inventory. I didn't even know that was possible. Am I upside down? No, I'm not. That's funny. I've never seen that before.
All right, now for the part that you've been waiting for.
But this is probably one of my favorite parts of the world, and I've said that about a lot of things. I know. You gotta understand, I'm not a gamer. I haven't been playing this for years like some people. And I'm not saying that to put anyone down. Like, if you've been playing for me Minecraft for years, honestly, I'm jealous because you've got so much experience. I'm just saying it because, for me, this is a huge feat. This is a big build for me. This took so long to plan, and I don't normally plan my builds. The Space Haven, we have to talk about it. I had so many friends give me their input on how it looked. It is so cool. I love that it tells a story. I love that you can just walk around it. Did I build the main structure without wings? Yeah, I did. I built the main shell of this without wings. I forgot about that. And I love the interiors. This whole thing is so impractical. I never come in here, but it's just so cool. It's just a typical mega build, and there's the dragon egg. I'm not gonna punch it, but I really want to punch it, but I've got my fingers off of the mouse buttons because I am resisting the urge to punch it that much. I keep forgetting about this bathroom, though. This is such an awkward... this is such an awkward space. It cracks me up.
Aww.
Also, in case none of you got this reference, now that I can say it because we're not doing any lore right now, these are obviously the three other members of the Chunklock series who invited me to join them. So we got Lane, Oda, and Millie. Chunklock was one of my very first times being able to collab with people in a survival series, and they were very generous to let me join them, and I am having so much fun. Although one of my absolute favorite parts of this whole build is the storage room. No. Although it is very pretty. This. Yeah. 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 I think it's coming together. This is kind of working out. This whole Minecraft thing? Yeah. Who knew? This whole junk drawer thing? Never would have guessed. And you know what? From up here, you can barely tell the paths aren't done. Well, it could definitely use some touching up, but you know what? For episode 20, we're not doing too bad. It doesn't look too shabby. I'm pretty happy with it right now. But I think I've talked your ear off long enough. So thank you all for joining me on this little world tour that literally no one asked for. Thank you for joining me on today's episode, because I think that is enough for right now. I am very happy with how this world has come along. I am very, very happy with my decision to start making Minecraft videos 1 year ago. And I am so, so happy that all of you are enjoying it, as evidenced by the 400 subscribers. Oh my goodness. I never thought I'd do... I never thought I... No. Nope. Never. Why do you watch me? But that's enough sap. No more sap. I promise. But as the sun's setting, I just wanted to say thank you all so much for watching. If this is your first time seeing one of my videos, then hello. Sorry, this was kind of a weird episode to jump in on, but welcome to Minecraft Junk Tour. We're on episode 20 and I am very sentimental right now. Okay, you know what? Never mind. It's too dark for this. It's too dark. I'm waiting for the sun to come up. So much of every Minecraft video that you've ever seen is just the whoever made it waiting for it to be nighttime. My cinematic lighting is gone. There. Where was I? Well, if this is not your first time seeing one of my videos, then please consider subscribing. But you know, only if you want to. Make sure to leave any questions, critiques, or cries of shock down in the comments below. Names for the villagers if you think of them, and any other build ideas or ideas in general for the series, because, you know, by episode 20, believe it or not, I am starting to run out of ideas. What else is there to do in Minecraft? We still have more space on the island. It doesn't look cluttered enough yet. So make sure to leave any of those suggestions down in the comments below. I'd love to hear them. And as always, I will see you in the next episode of Minecraft Junk Drawer. Goodbye, all. Goodbye. Gosh, we made it to 400. 400 subscribers. That's ridiculous. Hey, look. Past Izzy. 400 subscribers playing Minecraft videos. Video games aren't useless. I am so out of words. Sorry, guys. That's how it is, unfortunately. I am human. I ran out of words. Alright, that's probably a good thing though. I should probably be done. I should let you get back to your day. I hope you have a good day. Thanks for joining me.